What's up, guys? So it's time for us to get started on a new project here. Just had this package come in. Bet you can guess what it is. No? Okay. It's a guitar. So one of my viewers has sent me this acoustic guitar. It just showed up, and it's gonna get a custom paint job just on the face of it. We're gonna limit the area that we're painting to just the face so that we don't have to worry so much about affecting the sound of it, because as everybody hopefully agrees, acoustic guitars are, you know, a little finicky, and their sound is highly dependent on that soundboard and basically how their construction is and how they're coated. So we're gonna be doing a custom airbrush job on the face of this in nitrocellulose lacquer. I know you guys have seen me do a nitro paint job before, but this one is gonna be a pretty intricate airbrush job, which will be interesting because nitro is not the most fun thing to airbrush with, but we don't wanna risk using a different kind of paint on this because it's an acoustic and we don't wanna mess with how it sounds. So I'm gonna get started unboxing this very carefully now. And let's hope that that it arrived in perfect condition, unlike that one guitar that we did a similar paint job on. It's gonna be a box within a box. It's always a box within a box. Well, guys, that is a beautiful guitar, and it appears to have arrived in perfect condition. So I took one look at it as I was pulling it out of the box, and I was like, oh, okay, better put down fresh paper, which I have done, and wash my hands so I didn't get that cardboard residue on it. Look at this thing. That is beautiful. I'm glad it's got a nice dark, looks like ebony. Nice dark fretboard and tailpiece here. That's gonna go much better with the paint job. It's just an all-around beautiful instrument. So the way that I understand it is that the viewer who sent me this is actually getting it, well, bought the guitar and is getting it painted as a gift to a friend of hers who just had a child. So the airbrush job is gonna be relevant to that, of course. And yeah, I'm excited to get to work on this. Excited, but of course nervous. It's got a very thin finish on it. I can feel the grain of the wood through it, which is good because it means that I won't be adding a bunch of paint onto what is already a bunch of paint. But at the same time, it means that the finish is gonna have an effect on it because it's so thin. It's also got a bevel. I don't know if I can get close enough for you to see that. Yeah, it's got a bevel here for like the binding almost. So that's gonna be a little different to work with than I expected. But the outside of the guitar, of the face of the guitar when I paint it, is gonna be black, and that bevel is black. So I think it's all gonna work out quite nicely. I'm very excited to get to work on this. And yeah, stay tuned. In the next video, we will get started on the taping and prep for this, and then we'll move on to the airbrushing. Hey guys, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up so it'll be easier for other people to find, and subscribe to stay up to date with all the cool projects I got coming out. Also, a big shout out to Sovereign King, who does the vast majority of the music for my channel, way better on guitar than I am, and to Troy from Noise Guitar Mods. I'll put the link in the description. The man is a great guitar tech, and he's taught me most of what I know about how the internals of these things work. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed yourselves. See you next time.